everyone. Thank you so, so, so much for clicking on this video. The fact that you are willing to sacrifice a few minutes out of your day to consume my content really means the world to me, and I really do appreciate it. For those of you that are unaware, I review everything that gets released on Netflix, and I've also started a playlist, which this video is going to fall under, called Netflix Analysis, where I basically break down specific things within Netflix, whether that's a new movie, new series, new show, or in this case, a new announcement. And we're going to be talking about the announcement of the new He-Man and the Masters of the Universe series. Now, I think Netflix has to actually just stop and really think about what they've done. So as we're all aware, we just had Masters of the Universe Revelations be released on Netflix, and the reviews were completely contradictory there. We had people that loved it, people that hated it, but ultimately it split the fan base apart, much like The Last Jedi in Star Wars. We've got this film that completely separated the fan base. And so I had my own opinion about that as well, and you can check my opinion and my analysis by clicking on the link in my description and also a little bubble that just appeared. And you can also watch my Netflix reviews of the series as well. But I felt very conflicted about it as well. And so we've got this series, Masters of the Universe Revelations, that lots of fans believe has betrayed the core legacy of He-Man and the Masters of the Universe, the original series. And then you've got other fans that have embraced it. But you can't deny the fact that it is incredibly controversial. And we can break down everything Kevin Smith promised and all of his lies, and we can break all of that down. But there's one thing we can't deny, and that is the political messaging within the show. So we have this situation now where fans have been given a property that they didn't necessarily want, and it's caused a rift in the fan base. And you would think Netflix would do everything in their ability to try and fix this. But that's not the case at all, as Netflix has just announced a new He-Man and the Masters of the Universe series, and I was speechless when I saw the trailer. This is not He-Man and the Masters of the Universe. The fact that it uses the same name as the original series flipping drove me up the wall. You look at this reboot, and visually it has nothing in common with the original or any other reboot that has come after that. The difference between this reboot and the Kevin Smith one is that the Kevin Smith one was shrouded in controversy because of its political messaging, but this reboot seems like it just loses any respect for the original He-Man series. When I look at this, I think you could take these characters, change their names, and you wouldn't know it had anything to do with the He-Man property. And I think that's the issue here. I feel like this series exists simply to make money and use the He-Man label to do that. And in this incredibly sensitive time for He-Man fans, you should be giving them a property to regain their trust, not to use and abuse them. So this new CGI reboot has been marketed as for kids. It's a series aimed for children that they can really enjoy and engage with. And I'm just sitting here going, okay, cool, perfect, fantastic. But the two latest He-Man properties then don't seem to be made for fans of He-Man. Yes, the original series was aimed for younger boys. But the truth of the matter is there are people my age and there are men who love that series. And so you've got to recognize that that is the existing fan base. Those are the guys that still buy the toys. When you go into YouTube, you type in He-Man toy reviews, it's men that are busy reviewing it. Those are the fans of the series, and it feels like Netflix is constantly doing everything in their power to make a He-Man property for anyone but the fans. So this new CGI rebooted He-Man and the Masters of the Universe is going to come out on the 16th of September, and that is just under a month away. So guys, as you can see, I'm busy editing this video right now, and I do want to say, I don't think that this series is going to lack passion. I do really need to stress that. I don't think this is going to be a badly made series either. I just feel like it's definitely not honoring the origins of He-Man. Again, you listen to the voice acting, you see the animation, it all looks absolutely phenomenal. But my main gripe is, if you were to change the names of these characters, there's no way you'd be able to tell that this is supposed to be He-Man. The He-Man reboot from the early 2000s still stands as one of the greatest He-Man properties to this day, and fans are still talking about it. I had people in my comment section on my review for Masters of the Universe Revelations talking about how much they enjoyed the reboot from the early 2000s. And that's what I just do not understand right now when I look at the Netflix properties. We've now got two He-Man reboots, but none of them seem to respect the original series or respect the fans. And if you're going to be rebooting something, if you're wanting to make money off of an existing property, surely the people you're supposed to be appealing to are the fans. So I know I sound incredibly negative in this Netflix analysis, and I know I haven't even actually watched this reboot series yet, so it might completely blow me away, it might completely surprise me. But off of my first glance, I can't help but feel like He-Man fans aren't being catered to. There was also supposed to be a Masters of the Universe film that was released in March this year. But I have no idea what's happening with that because March has come and gone and I've been doing a bunch of research and I can't find anything to do with this film. So it feels like we could have definitely had a tidal wave of He-Man properties, but from the looks of it, none of it shares the core principles or values of the original He-Man series. And as a fan, that's incredibly scary. So guys, I would love to know your thoughts. Comment down below your opinions on this new He-Man reboot as well as Masters of the Universe Revelations. If you guys haven't yet, head over to my community tab. You can see there I let you guys rate and review every single new Netflix property. And there is a tab there for Masters of the Universe Revelations. I'd love to know your guys' thoughts there as well. But guys, thank you so much for watching this video. You guys are the best. You're awesome. If you haven't yet, please subscribe. And I hope to see you again in another review.